All right.
Okay.
It was paused and now we are back with Capricorn.
Yes, Capricorn. So now the child has become, you know, he's more grown. He's grown into a man. Now he's, he knows what is good, what is bad. Now he wants to just, he's on the lookout for some reputation. Now that he has, he's somewhat out of the miseries in the ninth house zone. So now he's moving into the name and fame, reputation. He's looking at the place of work. He wants to see exactly. And he is too much into that growth in life zone now. He's very laborious because it's a Saturn own sign. So it will always be, you know, like doing something or the other kind of a person. I've not seen him sitting idle either, you know, with the Cancer, with Capricorn people. Cancer, Gemini people and Capricorn people, they will not sit idle. They'll be doing something or the other. They have thin body. They have weak body because they grow very slowly because it is a Saturn owned sign. So they will grow very slowly and maybe they will not even gain that height also, you know, or maybe very gradually they will gain that height. They have their frame will be very, you know, bony and very weak. Their face is thin and oval. They have very deep set, other zodiac signs have protruding eyes. They have deep eyes. You know, they have, the eyes are not protruding. So you can make, okay, this is a thin, tall guy who has a very, you know, brownish kind of a complexion. So he is a Capricorn rising sign. You can make out. And then he has a very prominent nose also. Long arms. And height could be, you know, mediocre height, not too tall. I have not seen them too tall. What do you think about Capricorn, Babaji?
Yeah, Capricorn, I have seen, they're very humble in their behavior. Most of the cases I have seen, even if I have seen Sun is in Capricorn, even then, or if Sun is in the ascendant in Capricorn, even then I have seen. And right. They like to kind of understand, you know, that, I mean, if you tell them that, okay, you know, I can't do this. I'm sorry. You know, I tried my best. And then they kind of understand you, I have seen. But with guys like Leo, they are like, no, you must do it. And regarding appearance, I have seen, they can, if Mars is associated, they are very much disciplined. They like to work for, you know, like sports and all this very much, but that they do it just for fun, I have seen. Not that, you know, they want to be like, you know, like Taurus or somebody, you know, I should look, but just for fun they do it. So physically they are very active sometimes, I have seen, if Mars is associated. And
maybe time, Scorpios have that, you know, because sixth house is Mars sign also, so they are more into athletics and all.
Yes. And regarding height, what you said is so true. With Capricorn, I've seen. And they're quite timid, I've seen in my and in my friend circle. And sometimes I've seen like some of my friends, one or two of them I know Capricorn related. Like when we were of the age, you know, around 7 to 8 or 9 years, then some of them could be very tall. But as, you know, the age started going, their growth was a bit stunted. And this is something which I have seen, but again, it's depending on the chart, of course.
So many things, yes. It's just that it's just a general interpretation of how the person.
Another thing I have seen with Capricorn is, in my limited knowledge, that they are not too much obsessed with, you know, like looks or something of that sort. No.
They are not.
Yes, they are like.
They are not. Saturn on signs won't be. Yeah,
they're like, okay, whatever. I mean, they will do the necessary dressing and whatever is required to go into a party and all, but you will not see
present
them. See them wasting 6 hours for decorating themselves. I have not seen that. In fact, I know sometimes people tell them the opposite, that why do you don't put some emphasis on, you know, dressing or grooming up yourself? Why don't you try this dress? Why don't you try that? So till now, I have hardly seen anybody who is flashy or who likes to show off, you know. And even with social media and stuff, I have seen that they're not too much into, you know. They will observe it from a distance, but they're not like, we want to keep posting and boasting how great our life is, you know. And that is why I have seen these people, they have the least problems in marriage, I have seen. Anyway, that's a part of the nature, but this is what I have seen.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Right. Nice. Now coming to the 11th zodiac sign, Aquarius. And these people are now, this man who is growing, and now it has reached the second last zone of the zodiac signs. So he is feeling that, you know, he wants to accumulate some wealth and must invest in a proper channel so that, you know, because he's earned a lot now, he's done everything in life. Now he wants to just save and keep that money for future generations. Now he wants to invest where the money will stay, because it's almost the end zone of life. So end, he picks it. Yeah, he wants to just go. Now he's just picking up and choosing up friends. He's you know, around him, he's very calculative, he's very careful about the people he mingles with. Now these natives are very tall. They are tall, they are lean, unlike the Capricorn people, the Saturn on sign again. Now, provided there is no malefic influence, I want to keep that in mind, of everyone, that, you know, this is not the case with everybody. So just don't take it by, you know, thumb rule. This is not possible if there is some malefic influence. So this is because, if Capricorn was a female sign, this is a masculine sign. So I have seen females also having the male traits generally, you know, with the females are very materialistic. When they have this Aquarius rising, I've seen. They have very clear complexion. They look elegant. They have broad cheekbones. See, if you consider it as a Saturn-owned sign, so it should also have the similar kind of traits as Capricorn has. No, but it's not the case. These two are...
Ahu also co-lords, they say like this.
Yes, yes, yes. That is what I was about to say. That because its co-ruler is Rahu as well. So, and it is the Mool Trikona sign of Saturn. So it is something with strength to the sign even more there. So they have broad cheekbones. These natives have qualities deep down, but you know, they will show only when required. They have a lot of, because you know, the picture and how it looks, it's like going like this. So they have abundant knowledge within, but you know, when they don't want to show it they have deep knowledge, they have qualities like nobody else has. And they're very handsome looking people, actually. They have deep eyes, again, like Capricornians. So they have, that is their main feature, actually. They will be very serious looking, and with their eyes, they will convey a lot many things. And one more thing, being a barren sign, you know what happens? They become very indifferent at times. They'll be totally indifferent.
Yeah, this I have seen with Capricorn also, to some extent. Yeah. Saturn is...
They will suddenly, yeah. They will not compromise on any situations. They will not forget, not Capricorn, but this sign specifically, you know, they will not forget if somebody has done something to them, if they have got hurt. They will not speak anything, but they will not forget it either. They are like that, again, nature. So their area below the knees and calf sheen, that is weak. Their hair will be a little rough, Saturn sign. So their hair, both the Saturn own signs will have rough hair. And if Jupiter influences them, then they can be highly religious and spiritual, because this is a very, this sign is very pious sign as well. It's considered to be a very pious sign that way. So that gives, yeah, you were saying something, Babaji.
Yeah, I mean, without even knowing astrology or, you know, without knowing anything of this sort, then sometimes I've seen if people, you are having a chat with them, you know, using WhatsApp or WhatsApp in general, long chat sometimes. Then you will not see them using too many these smileys and, you know, all this.
They'll be like, oh, wow. Okay. That I didn't know.
Very straightforward, very direct, point to point. It's like,
They'll be writing each and everything, is it?
They'll not give all this, you know, red and.
Okay.
And with Taurus and all this, I've seen, they forget to write only. They use so many.
I've never observed that.
Yeah, and between Capricorn and Aquarius, the difference I've seen is that for Capricorn people, if you see from far, I mean, I can very easily know that he's a Capricorn because they'll be, you know, like sitting there and but that it, they look very similar to Leo sometimes. Capricorn and Leo, they look very similar. They're a bit reserved sometimes. But the thing, difference is, I have seen the Leos are expecting that, you know, oh, everybody should come and talk to me. You know, they should come and tell me how good I'm looking. But Capricorn may not be expecting it. They are like peaceful in their own self, you know. But and with regards to Aquarius, I have seen that they tend to be a bit more outgoing and a bit more confident. And Capricorn, sometimes I think they can be taking too much of unnecessary load, and you know, their face can look pale a bit sometimes, or people can ask, oh, everything is fine with you. But with
because they are so weak, you know, their composition is so weak, you know, when they're growing also, they don't eat much. I've seen they don't eat much, so they are not that very strong, their body and their immune system. I've not seen them very strong as compared to Leos. Yeah,
and with Aquarius, I've seen that they are a bit more outgoing, and they like to talk of ideas which nobody has ever talked, you know, scientists and all these people. With Aquarius, this is very prominent. And yeah, it's relatively easier to talk to Aquarius than a Capricorn, I would say.
Yeah. Just imagine there is so much of a difference. Each sign, like the rulership is of the same planet, but you see how much Virgo and Gemini, and how much you will know when I do the Pisces. You will know the difference between Sagittarius and Pisces also. There's a lot of difference.
Yeah, and with the two signs, Capricorn and Aquarius, this is a bit off track, but I feel there's one major difference which you can see in their personality also, is that the Capricorn is more focused on work and money and, you know, getting stuff done. But Aquarius knows that what is the purpose of doing all this? That, you know, you can be happy in life, you can, you know, share your happiness with others. That's the purpose, right? Mm-hmm. Otherwise, imagine you are earning 1 billion euros, but there's nobody to share your happiness. Life is miserable like that. So I think Aquarius, the behavior is more realistic on that side, that okay, even if I don't have things which I want in my life, but still whatever I have, I can, you know, kind of enjoy with that. But Capricorn can be a bit stuck with, you know, oh, this is not there, that is not there. And sometimes I've seen Capricorn can complain too much. By that also I know that
I think you have spent a lot of time with a Capricorn person. I can make out.
I have seen many Capricorn group and in my friends.
Yeah, I can make out. Lovely. No, good observation actually, you know. And smiley thing, I didn't know. Thanks. Because I don't interact with anybody like that on the chat. So I don't really know any Aquarius. So and coming to
Aquarius,
the last sign,
Aquarius and Leo are also very similar sometimes. Aquarius and Leo, but there's a difference sometimes. Because, you know, they are 7 houses apart, so sometimes their behavior is similar. Like Capricorn and Cancer also, they can be reserved sometimes, but there's a big difference, you know.
Yes.
All over to Pisces.
They're emotionally practical, actually. Cancerians can be emotionally practical, but Capricorns can be practically practical. That's
all over to Pisces.
They're balancing, actually. All the signs are balancing each other. 1-7 axis is a balancing sign, actually. So
yes.
I don't have to go there, actually, right now. Finish this. Pisces. So now coming towards the end, this man has performed his duties well, done everything for everybody. Now it's time to get into the spiritual pursuits of life. Now he wants to look for a guru, or he wants to get into that zone of spirituality. So he's on a lookout for a guru. So these natives are they have that on their face. They are on a lookout. So they are very short, they are plump, and they have short limbs, and a lot of tendency to put on weight. And they have a broader forehead also, they are well boned, and they love to visit holy places, generally I've seen, and love to travel for work. And it is a feminine sign, so they have a lot of nurturing qualities also. They are soft spoken, they have prominent eyes, as you know, Mina is eyes. This is the Mina Rashi. So Mina is not, it's fish. So it's like, you know, they have, the fish is like what, you know, they have prominent eyes. So it's, they keep, you know, they're looking here and there. So it's like that. They are always dependent on a guru, and they have a, I've seen they have always got a godfather in their life to bring out the actual them. They have, their life is, you know, very, and yes, they have very silky hair. They have light and silky hair. And of course, when Venus is looking at them, so their nose is also pretty, you know, prominent. So they are, anything else you want to say on of Pisces?
I'm not getting... Pisces people, as I have always made this, I mean, regarding all these signs, one thing you will always notice, you know, the planet that gets exalted in that sign, they will always, you know, kind of revolve around that. And the refined traits of that sign will come, of that planet will come out. For example, mm-hmm. like Aries, we said, you know, it's more of instinct based. But Capricorn are not like that. So similarly with Pisces people, I've seen their, the nature and the behavior is very refined, I have seen. Because mm-hmm. Venus is the planet which shows, you know, how much refined you are, you know, how much fine-tune your consciousness is. And Venus gets exalted there. So they like to dress, but in a realistic fashion. Not that you are, you know, going on dressing.
Yeah, because, you know, it exalts, Venus exalts there because Jupiter curtails the qualities of Venus. Because Venus is very luxurious, very flamboyant, very much into the world zone. So they, and cosmetics and all that. Pisces will not have anything of this sort if Venus is not predominant in their chart. If Venus is exalted specially in their chart, so in the Lagna, then they will have less inclinations towards all this, the worldly things.
Yeah, because the entire Rajas, which is Venus, is going into Sattva, which is, you know, like yes. that's very good. And in my experience, it's like they're very distinct, I've seen. Like most of the signs you cannot make out. For example, to some extent, Gemini you can know by seeing, but other signs are very difficult. But with Pisces, I know that they're like, I mean, because it's the highest evolved sign of the zodiac. Right. So this is not only with the appearance I've seen, their conduct and, you know, their behavior is very nice in general. I've seen, because it's mm-hmm. Jupiter and Venus, both are mixed, you know. Venus exalts yeah. there and it's lauded by Jupiter, and these two are the greatest benefics. So I've seen at a human level, I mean, not at the level of beauty or money or something, but at a human level, when you are with a Pisces person, you can connect very well, very easily. And sometimes I have seen their eyes, they, you know, the eyes will go sometimes, you know, they will have this
protruding eyes. Oh, puffy eyes.
Yeah, puffy eye bags, they call it.
Eye bags, yeah.
That can happen. And sometimes, you know, there's, because that bulky thing could be there, because now it's Jupiter and also it's a water sign, you see.
Venus is also a watery planet. So
yes. Their body can be, you know, like, and I've seen this with moon in Pisces, sun in Pisces also. Like wherever their body is, now you will see it's like going down, and it's like a bit, it's
baggy, heavy yeah. No, but Venus in the second house, I've seen they will always have eye bags. Venus yeah. in the second house.
Yeah, and Pisces, yeah, regarding that, I've seen their behavior is very refined, and very rarely I've seen they're having some marital issues or something like that. I mean, that could be there if that's there in their karma.
Sweet, soft-spoken people.
Yeah, and they're like very realistic in compared to, you know, like Scorpio and Cancer. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, they are water, but, you know, they are like, Cancer can be, you know, a bit too much.
This is a stagnant water, no? That is why. Pisces is a stagnant water. That is the only difference.
And yeah, so
in my... Cancer is a flowing, free-flowing water. So it's like too much of emotions.
Yeah, and in my opinion, I have seen, I mean, whenever either it is a friend or a family member or any client who I'm interacting or any YouTuber also, I'm doing recordings like this. Whenever Pisces is prominent, I know I'm going to have a good time there.
Wow.
So that's the only thing I will say about Pisces, nothing much.
Great.